आज का जो प्रोग्राम खासकर 21वीं सदी में तालीम के चैलेंजेस चैलेंजेस ऑफ एजुकेशन इन द 21st सेंचुरी के लिए हम जमा हुए हैं.
आज के इस मेहमान खुसूसी यानी चीफ गेस्ट से मैं इल्तिजा करती हूँ कि वो अपने ख्यालात का इजहार करें.
वी आर ऑल लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड, वी आर ऑल लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड टू ए जनरेशन of technological revolution, products of technological revolution, products of spiritual outcomes, products equipped with life skills to face the challenges of life, academic inputs is one, and facing the challenges of life is one. So the 21st century, we have to equip our youth, our children, as to how to face the life, what are the different life skills they have to imbibe. Education has to be accessible to everybody without any discrimination, without any discrimination. If you look back 100 years back, you won't find a lady member heading any institution. But now a change has come in the society. The women is empowered and the women is holding different posts, politics, everywhere, and they are marching forward. That's a change that has come in the society. And there is in the challenge of the 21st century is there are certain categories where they have to move forward. The disadvantaged children, the underprivileged children, the challenged children for whom the education was denied some time back. Now it is open to them. All the educational institutions have to admit the child without any discrimination. Whether it is a challenged child also, the head of the school cannot reject the child on the basis of the challenge. That is, if the child is mentally challenged or physically challenged, visually impaired, hearing impaired, learning difficulties. So any problem, the schools cannot deny admission to the challenged children. They have to take the child. The teachers cannot say, now I do not know how to teach these children. I do not know how to teach a mentally challenged child. I do not know how to teach a hearing impaired child. I do not know how to teach an emotionally disturbed child. The teacher cannot say that. That's a major challenge in the 21st century. The teachers have to find the ways and modalities to reach these children. They have to find ways, kis tarike se ye bachon ko sikhaya jayega. Kuch kami hai unme, magar kisi mein wo bachche zyada hai, kisi mein kam hai to kisi mein zyada hai. To aise bachon ko kis tarah sikhaya jaye? That is a challenge. So the universities have to change the curriculum. The university, in the examination system, the reforms have to come up. In the pre-service training and the in-service programs, our teachers have to be equipped. In the pre-service program, we can do that because they are with us. But already teachers who are working in the schools, how to equip them to face this challenge? The teacher will see in the classroom, they have to give admission to these kind of children. And when this, when the teacher finds a physically challenged child and a visually impaired child and a hearing impaired child, a mentally challenged child in the classroom, how the teacher has to teach them, what are the different strategies the teachers have to take up? So for this, there is a great need to help our teachers to improve their competencies and to improve and see that their performance is to the level of reaching the child. A teacher cannot say the child is not learning. Bacche seekh rahe nahi, ye hum nahi bol sakte. We have to find out how to teach the children, how to reach them. There is so much of technological changes that are occurring, and the teachers have to prepare themselves to these challenges. When the teachers go to the classrooms, they have to see what are the changes that are taking place in the society and how far the children are aware of these things, and help them to go forward, to reach forward. So access, retention, improving the quality of education, curriculum revision, training the teachers in service, pre-service and at all levels, different functionaries in the field of education, we have to make them aware of what is happening in the field. Headmasters, the people who are in the administrative posts should know what is happening around, what are the different challenges, and they have to move forward. Inclusive education, we are talking about the inclusive education. Special education and inclusive education. Earlier, the challenged children were put separately and they were given education. A child is mentally challenged, intelligence is less, social skills are less, then such children were put separately and taught. But now, these children are placed along with the other children and educational programs are taken up. It is not just mere placement of the challenged children with the other children. It is the emotional integration, it is the social integration, it is the inclusive as a whole perspective from all angles. So to achieve this, that is a major challenge. When we look at the educational scenario, we are finding the deterioration of the quality in some sectors. We are here in Maulana Azad Urdu University, a wonderful thing that has happened for the benefit of the Urdu, development of the Urdu language. Just now I was talking to Dr. Nazm Seher for some time back, and I place it before the dean also here that there is a lot of work to be done in the field of guidance and counseling with all the people, especially with the teenagers, and more specifically with girl students. The girl students who are coming from a conservative setup, who are having so many problems, but they fear to share with others. My colleague, Dr. Shaukat Beg, also is here. He also has done a lot of work in guidance and counseling. And we happened to visit some schools in Hyderabad, Urdu medium schools. And we could see that the girls are having so many problems related to emotional development and related to their physical development. Even the simple issues like menstruation, they are not aware of. They are not aware of the reproductive health. So these are the things which have to be, which needs a lot of guidance. And if they go to the people who do not guide them properly, then they are in the wrong hands. So it is the universities which have to take up different programs and cater to the needs of the adolescent children, especially the girl students. I emphasize this point, especially for the girl students. The services of the gynecologists are absolutely necessary. Number of gynec problems the girls wanted to share with us when we went around. They were so very eagerly asking in the Urdu medium schools, the girls, "Aap fir kab aayenge? When will you come again? When will you come again?" All the girls, you know, so very earnestly requesting. And I sincerely feel that is an area where needs lot of attention. It's one of the challenges. The child labor, the street children whom we see on the roads in our country is a sad sight. In spite of our independence, so many years, we still find a small children begging on the roads, the streets. So how to transform these little children into useful citizens of the country? The issues of corruption, terrorism, regional, lingual, communal barriers, which have seeped into the roots, have to be overcome only through education. Universal brotherhood, international understanding, fellow feelings, responding to one another like human beings, human to human response has to be achieved through education. So education is a media through which this can be achieved, and I think there is a long way to do that. And one of the important challenges in education is to bring about the behavioral changes, internal behavioral changes among our students at any level, whether it is primary, secondary, higher secondary, or whether it is the graduation level or professional or PG level, any level. This kind of a change, internal change, has to be brought about. A human being has to respond as a human being to other human being. So the universal brotherhood, the international brotherhood is a challenge. There are so many are there. I know all our enthusiastic paper presenters are ready with that. And I would definitely look forward to their presentations. So I thank Nazmus Seher and Professor Khatija. and Dr. Shaukat Beg for his kind words. So thank you all, and I look forward to your presentations.
Hamare sabse pehle paper presenter Dr. Manjusha yahan maujood hain, wo ab aapke samne apne paper ko padhenge. Unka topic hai challenge of making education humane.
When I was asked to speak about this topic, challenges of education, I thought, okay, this is pretty easy to speak about. But then when I sat and when I was thinking about education, the first challenge I felt was to work in this university where I really can't speak Urdu and form a bridge with you. So I'm speaking to persons who may not be really able to follow the ideas expressed. That was my first challenge. And then mera, what do you say? I know very little Urdu. Mera sar ghum gaya. How to speak to people who do not understand what I'm speaking? That was my first challenge. And anyway, I understand that the National University has multilingualism in it. So a little bit of it may be understandable. Actually, I want to present my opinions in three levels. The first level of it is, what are the challenges that education really faces today in the 21st century, globally, and the Indian challenges? That would be my first tier of focus. Second tier of focus would be education from a learner's perspective, or education from what do we want from it. That would be my second perspective. And third perspective would be my topic of making education more humane. What is the word humane in Urdu? Okay, the third level of my talk would be making our taalim insaniyat pasand. That will be the last. So first, when I was thinking about challenges of education, it just came like a cold water shower, you know. It just came like a cold water shower that education has is challenged in every aspect. You have education, challenge of education, primary education, because a child can't go far to the school. You have challenge of education in primary school because a child can't understand the textbook. You have a challenge in primary education because the child is not interested in the syllabus or in the school. That itself is a challenge. However, if you can see from a child's perspective, say, today is Sunday, he's so happy. Why child, you yourself, second Saturday, holiday, why seminar, you know? So it is not interesting, it is not appealing, it is not being utilitarian for us. So that's the first challenge that we are facing. Apart from access, you know, the divide in the education policy itself, That is the second challenge. You study for 15 years, 10 years of 10th class, 2 years of some 11th and 12th, and 3 years of graduation. After then what? So after we think we completed our studies, we realize that we are beginning our studies actually. How long can the parents go on supporting us? Is that not a challenge of education and a tragedy of education? We are 19 years old and then we realize that now I have to start doing something. Which is very sad state of a challenge for education. And then you have challenge of education for the higher education. How many of us can really go for higher education? not this virtual education through the distance mode or through the internet mode or the online mode. How many of us can really go in for a higher education? How many of us can overcome the rural-urban divide? How many of us can think about the curriculum and the material of education as a challenge? How many of us can think about education as also a stream of vocationalization? I'll be 19 years old, I only know how to read and write, that's all. And maybe today I'm learning some systems, some computers. But what else can I do? That is still a question mark after our degree. When I started thinking, I thought that this is very tragic. This is very tragic that you become an adult. You're 20 years old and then you find out that you're still in LKG and in nursery when you have to step out into the world. There is no national integration. That is the biggest challenge. So much intolerance. Whatever the basis of the intolerance is. So, the challenges go on and on and on. Finally, I thought education itself is a challenge, not challenges of education. Education as a challenge, how do you treat education? That maybe should be the next seminar point for us to take on. It's really beset so badly in this mire. Then, I come to the second tier of my talk. How much time do I have? This was my first tier, like talking about exploring the different challenges of education. The second tier of my talk was to think about why are we like this after 15 years of education? What is education meaning to us? What is it meaning? After 20 years, after graduation, what do you want to do? After engineering, what do you want to do? After BEd, what do you want to do? After becoming a doctor, what do you want to do? It all leads to one thing. That is a social observance today. It all leads to one thing, that you're as successful as much money as you can make. Is it not? You're as successful as saleable you can become. You're a very good teacher in the market. You enter a center for higher education and you get a lot of money. You're very good as an engineer. You're sought after by the corporates and you get a lot of money and you get a lot of respect. In the society, you make a mark for yourself. Maybe there is capability going along with you, but today, that is a challenge, that is the worst challenge we are facing today. Because education is turning out morons and robots and mechanics. We are not being human beings. Tell me, if I had a daughter, or if you had a daughter, for your sister, would you choose somebody who can drive his own car, or would you choose somebody who is very learned and goes on a bicycle? Somebody who is going on his bicycle, would you choose, who is very learned and a man of character? Or would you choose somebody who has some money, every month he gets good fat salary, and he goes by a car? See, there itself, the disparity, the parity is showing how our minds are working today. Let me tell you, your generation is at a better deal, at better crossroads. When 60s and 70s and 80s, these were the decades of materialism. We literally, when we were very young, we literally saw people making money, more money and more money. There was no end. But you youngsters are teaching us a lesson. You're saying this is enough. We want something else. And that is why we are thinking about challenges of education today. When we were talking about some, I would just give a small example. We were talking about some soft skill program, and I was trying to find out from elderly persons ki soft skills mein kya likhe jaye, what do you want? Bacche kaise talim paaye, kaise baat kare, kaise bole, how do they conduct themselves? I was talking to an elderly person, how should we write about it? She was really elderly and she was in an ashram. She said, kyun? Bacche pesh aane mein, padhne mein, bolne mein, talim ki kya zarurat hai? Ghar mein kaafi talim milti hai na? 10 saal school mein hai, phir alag talim ki kya zarurat hai? Teachers themselves give our role models. Why do they need training in soft skills? Why do they need training in communication? You know, that is how our elderly people 40, 50 years ago used to think. Can you think like that in schools today? Is our schooling, is our education making us talking people, writing people, thinking people? I'm not going to another area of ethical and moralities because that is very individual. We cannot really speak about it. Those things have to be learnt and caught, both. At least these things. If education is making us mechanical people without noble thoughts, without thinking people, only expectation and expectation and expectation, then one day will come when people will say, we don't want education because it is an industry. We are making an industry. It is becoming commercialized. So what do we mean by our education? Kya chahte hum ye system of education se? At least mere bachchon ke liye, education khatam hone ke baad, I would expect, it is a dream, but I would expect this dream that after 15 years, mere bachchon ko unka self-identity, I don't know the Urdu equivalent, please forgive me, self-identity ho unke, wo confident se khade hokar, apne aap ke baare mein wo log, they're confident about themselves. They're not diffident. They're not overconfident. They know their place in the society. They know their talent. They know what they can do. And they know what they cannot do. This much is enough for me, for my children. Can we expect that? Did 15 years of education tell you what is your strength? What is your weakness? What is your place in society? अगर हमारी क्लास में पूरे तुलबा में हम लोग 50 है तो 50 तुलबा में मेरा क्या प्लेस मेरा क्या प्लेस है अगर हमारे कम्युनिटी में 1000 लोग हैं रिलेटिव्स में तो 1000 लोगों में मेरा क्या प्लेस है मैं सबसे कम हूं या ज्यादा हूं मैं कहां हूं मैं 15 साल तालीम हासिल करने के बाद स्टिल आई एम थिंकिंग मैं और कुछ करना है नहीं बाय दिस टाइम आई शुड बी एबल टू रिफ्लेक्ट इनसाइड माय सेल्फ दैट इज एजुकेशन हम इंट्रोस्पेक्शन के जरिए व्हाट आई शुड बी डूइंग व्हाट कैन आई डू आई कांट आई नीड नॉट कंपेयर विद हिम आई नीड नॉट कंपेयर विद हर आई एम व्हाट आई एम Self-realization is the goal of education. It is the absolute truth all over the world. And now in German, the universities there are saying self-realization should come in through the sources of higher learning. Then this self-realization, I do not know, are we getting it through our education? Because it comes to two things. One is self-thinking inside. There is as much inside as outside you. You know, in the Bible, there is a sentence called as, thou art that. Aap wahi ho aur wahi aap hai. Aap electron hai aur electron bhi aap hi hai. Thou art that. Can you think in those terms? If thou, that means you are that. If you are that means you, every each one person is 100% successful person. 100% successful human being. That is the realization that I need to have through this education. And why this education is not telling me this? No. I think the time has come where, and also, you know, small things like being truthful, like being honest, like being very hardworking, like the eagerness to know, jignyasa. It never dies. It never dies. It is inside you and you want to learn more and more and more. Where are all these qualities? There are five aspects of a student. Very simple, living, very hardworking, and he never eats full. His concentration is like the concentration of an eagle. From a very great height in the sky, he looks down, and just comes down to its prey. That is what education has to make of us as students. Is it making like that? We have to have patience like a stalk. Pani mein khade rehta hai ghante, one morsel of food. On one foot it stands, you know, a stalk. That is what is to be imbibed in us. Is education making us like that? And the worst part, I think I'm taxing you, my last part, is the whole world today is divided into segments. Segments of the rich and the poor, of the haves and have-nots, of the color, the white and the black and the brown, of people who are technologically advanced and people who are not. The whole world is divided only into these segments today. Is it very important for a human being to respect another human being? If I want to respect Muhammad, do I need to see what color he is? If I want to respect Kausar, do I need to see whether she is my class or not? Or whether I am beneath her, whether I can go and talk to her? Is it necessary? We are not in the age of Hitler. At least India is the biggest democracy in the world. Then why? Then why do we not have this holistic thinking imbibed in us? Why there is no tolerance? You know, the translations in the world studies are going on in the German universities at a very huge expense of 200 crores, I suppose. And they are translating the world's greatest epics to learn lessons. India is so rich. India is so rich with a host of languages, with a host of religions, with a host of ethnic and the settlement groups here, down from 1000 BC onwards. We were living so amicably, so peacefully, except for a few 2000 years henceforth. Can we go back to our golden days when in our life we wanted food to eat, we wanted clothes to shelter ourselves, and we wanted high thinking, and we were living our respective religions, we were respecting each other, and we were very happy with one another? I would vote for an education which would give peace to each of my children. It would not tell me to wage wars. it would not tell me to want more and more in greed and lust and avarice. I want that kind of education which will make me more human. And that is the greatest challenge according to me today. Thank you very much.